can save the planet. As opposed to your common thread, the belief of Earth first, as the poor children are seeing on their dumpsters on the way to school, all of this programming of how horrible humanity is and how much they need to be removed from the equation, the answer actually seems to be quite the opposite. That more people actually nurture the land better, more, and it becomes far more abundant. But that's only if we were moving to an agrarian society, a society that was more focused on slack time, praise Bob, and nurturing, yes, and growing life. If this existence was to be cultivated, then no one could stop us, guys. I don't care how big Big Brother is. If 95% of us just said, enough, we're going to go out to the garden, this whole charade would end. I don't care how many bombs they tried or what they tried or what mind games they threw out at us, how many bin Ladens they brought back from the dead. It wouldn't matter. But you see, as long as we're caught up in the fight, as long as we're attacking the enemy, no solution will ever come, and they know this. And that's why they don't mind that you're out there seeking this data. They want it out there. They want Alex Jones ranting and raving. They want patriots. They want the people ready to shed blood. As long as you're in the game goes on. So how much before you realize the game is rigged? How much before you start to accept your beliefs that the world is ending? And then take the direct action, the direct route. Straight to the, all right, I'll go out to my garden, I'll read a book, I'll go live my life, I'll paint a great painting, I'll make a song, I'll do whatever I feel like, because none of this is real. How long will it take us to jump into that mode? How long? What will it take? Like I say, for me, it was my Y2K. Many people have conspiracy gateways. And then, as the levels start to compound, they start to see how mysterious this all really is. A lot of things start to lose meaning. So as I watch people try to rally behind and gather millions, if not billions of dollars to give to Ron Paul in hopes that maybe they could have a front man that would lead the stage in the direction they're hoping, they're still watching a stage. It's still a performance, and nothing is going to change. We can see this. Nothing has changed. Still, the agenda carries forth. No matter who gets into office, no matter what goes on, the agenda carries forth. And that's written on our backs.
It was my honor to talk to Freeman of FreemanTV.com on this very subject last month, and that entire interview is available for download at CorbettReport.com. But let's take a listen to our interview where we discuss the culture of life and how we can concentrate on living instead of dying.
We are now working on a film called Outgrow the Illuminati. And so we want to kind of combine these two thoughts together so that you can see the mistrust and then the trust. And what we have easily found, you know, as I found from Rainbow, is that everything does revolve around the food. Now, I was once working for Pizza Hut, and they came to me and said, you make the best pizzas in the entire region. Can you come and teach all the rest of the Pizza Hut cooks how to... your secret? And I looked at these corporate schmucks and I just laughed and said, love is an ingredient and I can't teach that. And their jaws just dropped. They didn't know what to think. They didn't know what to do with me. And I didn't take the position. I didn't want the position. I was teaching everybody about HARP and Y2K and everything else at that moment. While serving them pizza, right? So one part of this is planting seeds. One part is that we're trying to barrage people with the truth and beat it into their skulls. Now, the main thing here is that you just need to plant the seed and let it grow. You cannot force a plant to grow. You cannot force people to believe what you believe. You can only plant the seed and let them grow. So that's one aspect of this growing apparatus instead of trying to, beat this into your head. But what we started was a full community garden network, and it really once again fell together all synchronistically as my entire block decided it was a good time to start growing food. I think it's natural instinct, like animals sensing the flood or whatever. The earthquake's coming and they're running. Humans are all of a sudden like, wow, this is just obvious. I've got to grow some food. and it's happening all over with us. And so we've got a big worm farm going, and we've filmed how to create this and showing you how low our budget is and how small you can do this. And we're actually comparing and contrasting this with another permaculture project that's going on in the north of town, which is actually a government-sponsored, granted permaculture farm. And I think we're going to beat them on no budget whatsoever. I think we're going to outdo them. So we're going to document that at the same time. And so we have the worm farm going to get the good compost tea that we can then feed all of our plants with. We've got Ormus manufacturing going on, which is a method to create monoatomic elements, such as monoatomic gold, palladium, iridium. And this all comes out of Dead Sea salts or out of primordial salts. You release it, and we're gonna have a film on this. You release it through using a lye, that's the the chemical lye, and food grade, of course. And you bring it right to the right pH, and it actually releases all these monoatomic elements and detaches everything else, which you wash out. And so now you're left with just the very base ingredients of life structure. And we have been placing this stuff on our plants, and they have tripled in size. It's amazing what this stuff does, because all of our soil has lost all of its ingredients, all of its nutrients and things. So we're learning the methods to bring all of this together. And we have Jay the Terraformist, who's been a star on my show a few times. We moved him in, and so he's living on my couch now. And I love finally being the couch guy instead of the surfer. So at this moment, we have Gong the Planet, who is a crew that's going around doing rhythmic healings or sonic healings on people. And we have Jay the Terraformist here, and we have a number of the neighborhood all gathered, and we're all just digging in. And we're going to plant and grow some of the best food that we could possibly ever imagine. And it's going to be more abundant. That's the thing when you start to discover that a seed makes another billion seeds, it's just exponential. Abundance is here. It's just a matter of releasing the mentality of having money. Consider that we are building this garden, improving the land, doing all of this work. And this is not my property. I am paying a landlord to live here. And yet I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to improve his land. I'm going to build all of this garden and then leave it for the next renter when I leave here.
So how much of the culture of death and the lie that humans are a scourge on this planet and that there's overpopulation and we can't have any more people, how much of that lie do you think is propagated by the idea of detaching us from nature and trying to convince us that we can't do anything like this on our own?
Yeah, all of it. And they know, they know. That's why they're passing House resolutions to end these type of community gardens and to regulate gardening and the release of the vegetables out of such things. They don't want this. They know that we can empower ourselves with this. None of it has been true. Most of it came to us statistically based from the Club of Rome. And they put out a book called Limits to Growth. And it was this that was passed through every institution, through every university. I had to read it in college to say that humanity was expanding in such a grand rate that we would overgrow the planet in no time at all. Now, the truth of the scenario is that we find that people could, the entire planet's human population could probably fit comfortably in Texas. And as you drive across the United States, as I do so often, you'll find that there is plenty of empty space. The problem is, of course, water generation, power generation, and the problems that we have for just food, water, and power and structures. Now, these things are open. We just had the Pope talking with Mark Kelly on the International Space Station, and Mark's trying to explain to them, to the Pope, about how all of their new energies that they're using in the space station would free humanity and end all war and strife. And the Pope's like, yes, yes, that was just the most recent with the Pope and the International Space Station. As we start to look, and as this proliferation of intelligence is coming to us through YouTube, I mean, one of the greatest mystery schools out there, YouTube, anything you want to learn, there it is.
We're starting to learn all these new techniques on generating energy, generating things, and being able to, you know, run cars on water or run power sources with no problems or heat your house with biomass. You know, you've got your compost going outside. It's also heating your bathtub. Meanwhile, your bathtub's draining into your banana pit. You know, it's all one good cycle, and we're starting to get a gestalt or a holographic vision of how this all works. So what we really believe and what we've seen as far as what humans being caretakers of the planet is that the more people, the better, if we were focused on creation instead of destruction. And the more people, the more leisure time and the more food and abundance and everything else we would have. So we've actually found it to be quite the opposite, that there would be more paradise, more paradisical gardens around the globe, and less climate change, less destruction and all of that if there were more humans, if those humans were practicing agrarian societies.
I trust that the message of today's episode is not lost on the listeners out there, and the need to communicate this message is also not lost, because there is no doubt that we have been steeped in this culture of death, where we have been trained to think of death as a wonderful thing, and we have been so desensitized to death through all the various media that we consume on a daily basis, that we can hear about the mass deaths that are happening all day, every day, all around the world, in the various conflicts and various things that the elite are doing, and the wars that they are waging for their own benefit, and we are made to feel guilty for, if we are even led to think about it at all. And usually, more often than not, we are not made to think about death unless it suits the purposes of the controllers. And unfortunately, we have been trained to think that death is a wonderful thing and that humanity is a scourge on this planet, when the real scourge is the parasitical psychopaths at the very top who are puppeteering this system for their own gains, their own ends, to ensure that they propagate off into the future, and that we are not only culled, but actually willingly go to the slaughter. It is time to drop the ironic tone and the cynical stance and stop thinking of ourselves as oh so clever and avant-garde for thinking that humanity is a scourge, instead of something to be celebrated and propagated. It's time to choose life. That's all for this week. I am your host, James Corbett, thanking you for joining.